What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations, the official version of Vray 3.4 for Sketchup finally released. And today, I'm going to go over the user interface as well as the new material library. With that said, let's get started. After you install Vray, open up Sketchup and you will see three floating toolbars. The first one is the main toolbar, which includes the asset editor, the rendering button, and the Vray frame buffer button. The buttons on the second toolbar allow you to create a variety of Vray lights such as dome light, sphere light, and rectangle light. Wait, plane light? All of these lights already exist in version 2.0. What's new in version 3.4 are the mesh light and the adjust light intensity buttons. I've covered these two features in a previous video called Vray 3.4 for Sketchup Preview. In that video, I also cover other features like batch render, Vray fur, and mesh clipper. Those features haven't changed much since the beta, so I won't go over them again in this video. However, I will show you some new things in this official release. First, let's open up the asset editor and look at the new user interface. From left to right, you will see the material editor, light editor, geometry editor, and settings. Next to that is the render button and the Vray frame buffer, which displays your renders. If you look closely at the render button, you will see a drop-down arrow. Click on this and it will give you two more options. One of them is an option for you to export Vray scene file, and the other is the render with Vray interactive button, which is the same as Vray RT or real-time from the previous version. When using this mode of rendering, Vray will automatically update your render as adjustments are made to the scene. For example, if I were to make some changes like this, then you can see that Vray instantly updates our rendering. However, since I moved the camera in the viewport, it also changes the angle of the render. But if you want to make changes to the model without changing the view, you can click this button here and then proceed to make the changes. You can see that Vray still updates the scene, but it keeps the same framing for the rendering. Now, let's look at the new material library. You can do that by clicking on the material editor tab. Then if you were to click on the arrow on the left side, you see a built-in Vray materials library. With the official release, Vray now provides you over 200 materials that are ready for render. I mean, look at this. This is crazy. The library includes new materials such as bricks, concrete, asphalt, grass, leather, wood, and many more. Click on a category to open it in the library. You can then change how you view the materials with these buttons here and change the size of them here. Once you see a material you like, drag and drop it here to add it to the material list. Or you can simply right-click a material and select Add to Scene. You can then make changes to it through the Quick Settings tab. Or if you want to customize it even more, then click this arrow on the right to open up the Advanced options. Let's go back to the material list. You can see that the material preview is a little small. You can actually increase its size by hovering over this bar here and pull it down like so. There we go, that's better. Also, you can change how the material is displayed by using these three dots here. Here's what they look like. One final thing I want to show you is depth of field. With the new Vray, it is so easy to do a depth of field effect in your rendering. First, position the camera, now turn on Vray Interactive Render. Then in the Settings tab, go to Camera, turn on Depth of Field. Now click on Pick Focal Point and choose a spot on the scene that you want the camera to focus on. Then you can adjust how blurry it is using the Defocus slider. Once you are happy with the result, you can turn off Interactive Mode and produce a final render. And that is all for today, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a like. I'm super excited to explore more of the new Vray and make more videos for you guys. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't yet. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.